Now at 6, the polls open for early voting. The huge number of voters in the November election is expected to draw. The ballots are printed and the booths are set up for in-person absentee voting. Good evening, I'm Terry Sadie.
And I'm Kathy Michaelby. Officials are expecting the kind of turnout seen for a presidential race. And new at 6, 12 News' Shelby Croft is live at the Zeidler Municipal Building in downtown Milwaukee. Voters are trying to beat the crowds, I guess.
That's what I'm hearing, Kath, from the early voters, and plenty showed up here today. They think that people are going to flood the polls on Election Day, so they want to make sure their vote gets in.
I believe it's going to be a huge turnout.
Stephen Nathan isn't taking any chances. He just moved to Wisconsin and didn't want to risk a hitch in the voting process, so he cast a ballot as soon as he could.
I want to beat the crowds, too.
Stephen's instincts may be right.
We are figuring 200,000, 210,000.
What's anticipated Election Day in Milwaukee? About 25 to 35,000 more voters than 4 years ago. The absentee number in that election was 11,000. Milwaukee's expecting 20 to 25,000 this time.
And we don't have an incumbent governor running, so that always creates an enormous amount of interest.
In the middle of the Republican stronghold of Waukesha County, Brookfield City Clerk is expecting to come close to full voter turnout.
Okay, these are your ballots.
I would expect there's going to be everybody voting. Everybody voting.
I think we need a change, and I think a lot of people believe that, and I think that'll be a reason for more people to vote that normally don't vote.
Governor's races usually draw 78 to 80% in Brookfield.
The presidential is 90. This time, I think we're going to close in on the presidential.
Now, to request an absentee ballot, you must do it in writing and the request must be signed. You can vote absentee in person until the day before the election. Reporting live in downtown Milwaukee, Shelby Croft, WISN 12 News.